Welcome to this QuickBooks 2019 tutorial for beginners on how to set up an invoice template. So in QuickBooks, there's a number of templates that come preloaded into QuickBooks, and one of these is the invoice template. Okay, so this is going to be the template that pulls up every single time you pull up an invoice and you create an invoice in QuickBooks. And so you're going to want to customize this to your business. Okay. So, you know, the basic ones are fine, but they are pretty bland. And so what I want to do is show you how to set up a custom template inside QuickBooks so you can customize this to your business. All right. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to go up to the list drop-down menu, and you're going to see an option here that says templates. Okay. So we're going to click on that, and you're going to see a listing of all the templates that are in QuickBooks. So this is a sample company file. So there's going to be a bunch of them here. You may have just a couple in your company file. But what you can do is you can go through, and if you wanted to, you can go down here and you can edit these templates to change them how you want to, or you can set up a new one. Okay. So what we're going to do, we're going to go to new. All right. And we're going to choose invoice. All right. And you can see here that you can set up templates for all these other different forms. All right. So we're going to click OK. All right. So you get this screen here that says new invoice template. And you're going to see a preview over here of what this looks like. All right. So now what you want to do is you want to customize this to your company and what you want to show on your invoices. Okay. So the first thing, you can use a logo. All right. So when I click this, it's going to say, where's the logo you want to use? I got to select an image. All right. I don't have one right here, but when you have your logo, you can choose it and it's going to put it right on, the invoice. Okay. So I'm going to cancel that, but I like to use a logo, makes it look a little more professional. Okay. You can choose a color scheme. So this is if you are printing in color or if you're emailing these invoices. So let's say that we want to do blue and we're going to apply the color scheme. So you can see it changes here. So real basic color scheme that you can apply to the invoice. Now, if you want to change the font for the title, okay, which is going to be invoice, or the company name, address, labels. And if we scroll down here, you can see you can change the font for a number of these. So I want to change the company name font. Okay. So I'm going to click OK. And you can see it's a Times New Roman. The color is navy. If I want to change this to, let's say, maroon, and I want to make it bold, and I want to change it to 24. Okay. So you can see there it changed it, but it didn't change it to maroon. This is because we have the color scheme of blue. Okay. So we've got the company name bigger. All right. And we've got the address there. That's fine. Now down here, you're going to say the company and transaction information. So I want the company name. I want the address. I would like the phone number. Okay. And it gives you this prompt, use the layout designer. That's okay. I'll show you that in just a second. All right. And we want the email address. Okay. And we can say update information, and it's got this information here, company information. You can update that if you need to, and you'll see here that it puts my phone and my email down here. All right. So that's fine for now. We're going to change that in just a minute. Okay. If you do want a past due stamp to print on the invoice, let me make sure I get that off of there. Okay. You can have a past due stamp and you can print a status stamp, include the status of the form. Various statuses are paid, pending, received, void, and so on. Okay. So generally I like to include those just because, it'll print right on the invoice. Okay. So this is the basic customization. So you've got this, you know, basic setup here. And what you can do is go down to additional customization. All right. So this is where you're really going to start including things, you can choose to show just on the screen or just to print or both. Okay. So for example, if I didn't want the default title on the screen, I can take that off. If I didn't want the date, I can take that off. Okay. If I, you know, wanted to not print, but I want it on the screen, you can see I can take that off and it takes the date away. All right. So this is going to be your print preview right here. So you're going to go through and you're going to say, okay, there's a number of things on here. So for example, I would like the due date on here because I like to show that to the customer so they know when the due date is. Okay, we want to make this as easy as possible for the customer to pay you. Okay, all right. Now you can also go to columns, all right, and it's going to tell you, do you want to screen or print item description, manufacturer part number. You know, what I suggest is you play around with these. You can reorder them. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, or you can change this to be 2, 1, 3, 4. So you can change the ordering of the columns. All right. Now you can go over to footer and you can put different things on the footer. Okay. So you got a subtotal, sales tax, total, payments, credits, balance due. You know, you can put a disclaimer or something else at the bottom. All right. So there's a number of things that you can do here to change the template to customize it to what you want it to look like. All right. And then print. Okay. Use invoice printer settings. You can change those settings, print page numbers on forms when more than two pages, print trailing zeros if you want to, definitely not needed. Okay. Now the last thing I want to show you here is the layout designer. Okay. So the layout designer basically allows you to move that over a little bit, allows you to move things around. Okay. So for example, if I want to put this down here and I want to move these up over here. Okay. Right there. And we're going to put this right there. And let's say that I want to move bill 2 because this fits my envelopes when I'm sending these, or you just like the look a little bit better. Okay. If you want to move PO number over right there, sample. Okay. So you can see you've got a number of options to move things around. All right. So let me move this down here. Okay. So you're going to get this the way that you want it. And then you're going to click OK. Okay. So now it's going to take us back over here and then you can print preview this. So you can print preview to see what this is going to look like, how you want this to appear when you print things. And you can really customize this to how you want this to look for your business. Okay. So we're going to click OK. All right. We've got new invoice template. It takes us back to this screen. You can do other things here. You can also do this layout designer here. Okay. And then you just click OK. All right. So we've got new invoice template. I want to change the name of this. So I'm going to say manage templates. Okay. Let's see. I'm going to change this name to ABC Company Invoice. Click OK. Click OK again, and you'll see I've got it up here. So now when I go to create an invoice, I can go to create invoice and I can choose ABC company invoice. Okay. So you're going to use this template whenever you create an invoice for your company. Okay. So those are the basics of setting up a template for an invoice template in QuickBooks Desktop. Any questions whatsoever, any comments, feel free to leave those below. Also, head over to the QuickBooks University. Would love to have you as a member over there so I can teach you everything you need to know about how to use QuickBooks the most effective way possible. Head over there now, qbuniversity.org.